Do you have your passport? Did you get your shots? Girl, would you like to come back with Rob to America? America, 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 the beautiful. Do you have your passport? Did you get your shots? Who wants to come back with us to America?
David and I met on Facebook in January of 2017. I am 50 years old. David is around 42. I was attracted to him. I thought he was a nice looking guy. And we just started chatting every day and we would check in with each other multiple times during the course of the day. I completely fell for David because he was a man of God and he was a person I could really talk to, and it just drew me to him. It took David about a month to tell me that he loves me. 10 months into our relationship, David needed $200 because he was trying to get a job. He was trying to work, so he needed to go and apply. He needed to travel, put in applications. It did start becoming a pattern of money every other week. He needed money for a passport, for a driver's license. David needed money because the small apartment that he was living in, the roof started leaking, and he did have to go through some testing and training, so I did help him with that too. As a single parent, I was working long hours so that I could send him the money, a total of about $10,000. I was sending David money because he needed to get a job, because our plan was to hire an immigration attorney. David has been trying to get a visa, but because he couldn't come to the U.S. I finally flew to Nigeria. 5 days after I arrived, David and I went to the registry to get married. I married a Nigerian man, and I want to know if he's a fraud.
Their Nigerian wedding was 2 years ago, and Sherry said she's still waiting for her husband to come to the States. Sherry says he was supposed to come to America and marry her again in front of her family. That hasn't happened yet. But after multiple attempts to get a visa, David is still 6,000 miles away in Nigeria. Sherry says she's growing suspicious, especially after she sent him $1,600 for a visa she says turned out to be fake.
I've sent David money for 3 visas. The first time David applied, there was some type of discrepancy with a number that was incorrect, so the interview had to be rescheduled. When David rescheduled the interview, they declined him because David tried to apply for a tourist visa and the officer told him that he needs to apply for a spousal visa. The third time David told me he applied for a visa, he claims that his cousin knows a military police that works at the embassy that can help him to get a visa, but they needed more money. First, he said it was $980, and a couple months later, he told me that it was $1,850. For that visa, I sent David maybe a total of $1,600. I was feeling frustrated and I asked David, you know, could I see the visa? It took a while, but he finally did send me a snapshot of it. When I finally saw the visa, something just didn't look right. So I just sent a copy of it to the U.S. Embassy and asked them, was the visa a real visa or not? A U.S. consular lady told me that the visa that I have is handwritten in and their visas are printed out. The day that I found out the visa was fake, I just started hyperventilating. My chest tightened up. I had shortness of breath. I start running to the bathroom, vomiting. I just got on my phone and called 911. I'm having a heart attack. I trusted David, and I felt like I was deceived and betrayed.
Do you have your passport? Did you get your shots? Girl, would you like to come back with Rob to America? America, America, America. Do you have your passport? Did you get your shot? Who wants to come back with us to America? America, America, America.
Hey, ladies, how you guys doing? I want to send a warning of green card season, passport season, anchor baby season, especially coming from the continent, particularly Nigerians. They are known scammers. I recommend Black Americans to stay as far away from Nigerians as you possibly can. That is one group of Africans that is just treacherous to the Black American. But I want to bring awareness to this because I've seen so many stories, even in my personal life, of these type of green card and marriage scams with Africans, particularly Nigerians. When I tell you that this is something that they do, they prey on vulnerable Black American women, because unfortunately, a lot of Black American women seem like they just looking for love no matter where at. But I question some of the women who think they're going to find love from a third world migrant, an economic migrant that's looking for a better life. How is he going to provide for you if he doesn't have anything and you're sending him money? A lot of these stories are the same way. They send these men money. The men tell them how much they need money to pay their rent, their bills, et cetera, et cetera. And tell myself, I'm like, well, ladies, if you're looking for a strong man to provide, you're sending him money in this third world country. You don't know this man. Well, the list goes on. And I'll say this, even the ones that are American citizens don't deal with them either. There's nothing positive about these situations. I know women who dated and married Nigerian men in America, and it has been one of the worst decisions they have ever made. We don't mesh well with these people. They are just not good for us. Again, it's not just Africans, but Caribbeans too. There'll be so many stories of Black American women being targeted by these men for green card statuses. And once they get to America, they divorce them and bring their real family over. These men do not genuinely love you. They do not like you. They don't want to start a family with you. It is just to get the golden ticket to America. And I want Black American women to really wake up and pay attention. They will love bomb you because, unfortunately, and this is going to sound bad, a lot of Black women have never experienced love before. They've never experienced a man really loving them and taking care of them and showing them and doing nice things for them. So when they get these foreign men to love bomb them, they fall into a trance and all logic goes out the window. We've seen it time and time again. We've seen the unfortunate demise of so many Black American women in the Gambia. And a lot of the stories are in reference to being in relationships with some man. Because the reality is, a third world African or Caribbean can do nothing for you. If you can't get a man that to provide and protect for you in America, where he has all the resource and access, it is nothing a third world migrant, economic migrant, is going to do for you, especially if you send him money to pay his bills, to pay his rent, to help him get a green card. It's so sad and unfortunate. It always is a lot of older women who fall for this. And I just really feel really bad for you women that are in your maybe early 50s and mid 50s that fall for this, because I guess your whole life you have just been done wrong by men in America or whatever. And you feel like going to a third world migrant is going to save you from your issues or whatever. And you're seeking companionship, but I just want some of you guys to use discernment and think, these men don't love you. They don't want a future with you. They just want to get to America. Just like in this article, Nigerian man will get with a woman, come here, marry her, and then move along. He dumps her, bring his real family over, or do whatever. It's all about getting that American citizenship and connection. That's why I say don't have sex with these men, don't have their babies, because it anchors them to America. I'm telling you guys, the fastest way to get citizenship is through marriage, and I hope America cracks down on it. I even have my own personal story from college. Like I told you guys, I didn't really interact with Africans until college. I don't know them. Never grew up with them. They didn't live in my neighborhood. They didn't go to my high school, middle school, nothing. And when I was really in college, I was in a study group with one. His name was Moby. I forgot what it was short for. But I remember doing graduation. I think I told you this guy's story before. He was from Nigeria, of course, because it's always them. Nigerians are the biggest scammers. I tell anybody to stay away from Nigerians. You guys, I don't want to, you know, put it out there that all Nigerians are bad, but I have never had anything positive with Nigerian. It's just something about them is just very scandalous and sneaky and shady, and I just prefer to keep my distance from them. out of all the Africans. Stay away from Nigerians. Don't do business with them. Don't be friends with them. I'm sorry. Some of them may listen to this and say, oh, that's wrong. You can't paint us with a broad brush. But they have just always been a negative group of Africans. We've seen it in our politics. We've seen it in our media. We've seen it on social media. We've seen it blatant in our face with the disrespect, the Akata, the list goes on. They are some nasty Africans and some of the worst group of Africans on the continent, and not just by from us, from other Africans too. They are a nasty piece of work. I do not care for Nigerians. I stay away from them. I'm not disrespectful to them, but when I find out they're Nigerian, I just slowly back away and move around quietly. I just move around quietly. I don't want to get to know you. I don't want to talk to you. I damn sure don't want business. I know I'm all over the place, but I was at a flea market or something, and I'm not saying I have a problem with Africans. And they were selling some stuff, like, you know how they always hustling, which is fine. It was a flea market. But when I found out he was Nigerian, I was like, I am not giving him my bank card to tap or to swipe. I don't trust them as far as I could see. And when doesn't it come from a transaction outside of cash, I don't fuck with them. I don't freak with their businesses. I damn sure don't eat their food. It's something about a Nigerian just very, very sketchy to me. They just all scammers to me. I don't care. They're in the professional setting. Nigerians are the worst group of Africans, and it is the truth. So I steer clear of them. Now, any other group of Africans, I really haven't had any bad interactions. But I mean, I don't particularly be around any of them, Africans or Caribbeans. I keep my distance from all of them because at this point they get on my nerves and they always in our spaces. But when it comes to certain people and Africans, I stay away from them. Let me tell you something. Credit card. I looked at that man like he was crazy. It was around Christmas time. It was a flea market. I think he was selling like these little beanie hats or whatever. And I like to buy a lot of hats to give out at that the hat and glove drive that we put on the big Christmas tree. And when I tell y'all, I was like, I would rather go to the Dollar Tree and buy a whole bunch of hats and scarves there because I do not trust these people. I'm sorry. And my husband was like, what's wrong? I was like, nah, I'm good. He was like, well, this is a good deal. You get a whole pack for like $5. I was like, mm-mm. I don't care how cute the little hats is. I don't have no cash. You don't have no cash. I could have walked to ATM, but I didn't feel like it. I like to just pay with my card and go. But when it came to tapping, oh, hell to none. I was looking at black people doing business. I said, I wouldn't be surprised if 2 weeks later, a month later, they get all kinds of fraudulent charges on their car. I know that's messed up, but they just leave a bad impression on you. They always in the news for scheming and scamming, whether it's marriage scams, romance scams, 419, Yahoo Boy. They are just scammers. And unfortunately, Nigerians have a bad rap around the world. Their passport is banned. Other countries don't want them there. They have a bad reputation in China. They fake to be black Americans because their reputation is just mud. And this is why I hate the fact that we be trying to connect ourselves to out of all the Africans in the world is Nigerians. They are no good. And the crazy thing is, they'll say, stay away from the Akata. And in my mind, I be thinking, no, we need to stay away from you. And I wish black Americans on some platform will call them out. Lord, please invite me. Because the minute some African, particularly a Nigerian, talk about, we need to stay away from the black American, they thugs. Nigerians, you are absolute savages. Y'all, that's not even talk about the stuff they do to their people in Africa, the women, the tribal, the stuff. They savages over there sacrificing women and children, eating albinos and stuff, eating bats. Let's not even talk about Nigerians. And then outside of their countries, they always known for scammers. They on the Interpolis. So when they say stay away from the black American, I'm like, what? Our parents or somebody should step up and say, no, stay away from the Nigerians. Don't let them in your house. Don't do no business with them. Keep them far away from you. I say again, Nigerians are by far the worst Africans ever deal with. And as you can see, they're the leading ones in this damn marriage scam. Just look it up. But ladies, I want you guys to have discernment when you're dealing with them. But let me get back to my story. So when I was in college, it was this one named Moby. I forgot what his name was short for. But anyway, it was time to graduate. And when you're in America on, a student visa, the day you graduate, you're supposed to be out the country. So I remember we were studying for our finals all in the group. And he was like, yo, I really don't want to go back to Nigeria. I really don't want to go back. He was looking for a job to sponsor them. And when they come here, a job have to sponsor them, mean be responsible for them. And he couldn't find a job to sponsor him. I told y'all this story. It was two Nigerian guys. One was getting his MBA. And he was just like, you know what, Target, he was going to work. He went for an interview for Target, and Target told him straight up, like, it's pointless, and it doesn't benefit us to sponsor an immigrant with NBA when we have several Americans that we don't have to do have to sponsor, because according to him, Target like will be responsible for him in the country. So Moby was like, he was having the same problem. So he was running around, y'all. He even tried to go to Congress. I swear to God, to try to stay in the country, because what happens on your license, it tells you the day you need to be out the country. And NBA had the day that he needed to be out of the country. So what they'll do is they'll keep re-enrolling the school. Next thing you know, he was going to nursing school, y'all. I'm like, how you go to, you went from NBA to law school to nursing school. They will keep staying in school to stay in America, because that's the only way they got to do it. So I remember him saying, you know, we should get married because I moved to Boston. We ain't got to live together. I was so appalled. Like, if you ever think, because that was nice. Again, I didn't have a problem with them. I still don't. We was in a study group, and he was just at this point desperate to stay in a country. And I was so disgusted at the time. I had told my boyfriend at the time I was married to my boyfriend. Oh, not married. I said, gosh, look at me. I was with my boyfriend, and my boyfriend was older than me at the time. He was an attorney already, and he was like a TA. And I had told him the situation. He was livid. He's like, what that motherfucker say? I said, yeah, I think it was harmless, but it was the fact that he was like, yo, we can get married. I'll pay you. And this is the first time I've ever heard of this. He wanted to move to Boston because I think it was some job he wanted up there. But I'm not sure if he got it because, like I said, he was an immigrant and he was on a student visa and the job would have to sponsor him. And I just was like, you ever heard of this before? And he was like, yeah, I heard this motherfucker got something there. I said, it ain't worth it, because absolutely not. But it was just showing his desperation to try to pull this con. They do this all the time. I knew a Nigerian who was from the Delta, Niger Delta, and he was looking for a woman to marry so he could stay in the country. He ended up finding some gullible black woman, had a baby with him, and then he was trying to bring over his nephew, but he had to find some bank statements. And I remember him telling me how he needed to borrow somebody bank statements to show that they got a lot of money, so it can show that you are able to take care of the person that you're sponsored to come over. When I tell you scheme after scheme after scheme, you will hear these people talking about it. Not only do they have a lottery system, which I think needs to be abolished. A lot of Nigerians come over here on a lottery system, and the list goes on. And the first group of people they targeted is black Americans, because some of us are so gullible. But I just want all black Americans, men and women, to be conscientious of these people. Think about 90 Day Fiancé. We already know how that is. These people is only looking for the golden ticket. America is the land of opportunity, unfortunately. I know we have criticism of America because of our history here, but the reality is people are dying to get here. We see them run across the border. We see so many people press to get in this country. You see what they're doing now, that they will target you. And all they try to do is either put a baby in you, anchor baby, or men try to get you to get them pregnant, because once they get pregnant, they are anchored to this soil. That's why we call all you immigrants and you first gens and second gens, you are anchor babies, and that's just the reality. But you guys, tell me what you think about this situation. What can we do to warn more black women and black men and just Americans in general to watch out for these marriage scams, especially coming from the continent? Okay, guys, like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll talk to you guys in the next one. Bye. If you get mad, even if you get offended, ma'am. So what you gonna do? Because I guarantee you, you can beat me up.